some times we had. I hope you smile and know that through the good and through the bad, I was on your side when nobody could hold us down. We claimed the brightest star and we came so far and know that you won't forget. Whenever you
everybody. Shall we bow in prayer? Father, we praise you, the Almighty, ever-present, all-knowing God. You have brought us through this amazing journey. It's not always been easy for the faculty or the students. We've been exhausted, discouraged, and even wanted to quit. You saw us through exams, clinicals, and the dreaded checkoffs. We have suffered failures, illnesses, and even deaths. We have rejoiced with births, marriages, and now graduation, and you've been faithful through it all. As these new nurses enter the noble profession of nursing, bless them with your constant presence. Grant them the courage and boldness to advocate for those you have called them to serve. Help them to listen to your still small voice telling them, this is the way, walk in it. We also ask that you protect these graduates as they head off into the future. You have done so much, and we ask that you continue to offer strength, courage, and discernment as they head into a world that is not always pleasant, peaceful, or accepting. May they experience love and friendship and the knowledge that they are making a difference in people as they fulfill your plan for their lives. We will no longer be meeting as teachers and students, but as colleagues. Oh God, as they go forth into the world of healthcare, bless them with mentors to guide them, and in due season, may they also serve as mentors. Thank you for seeing them through this journey and now going before them as they venture forth. In your precious name we pray. Amen.
Welcome. For those of you that are standing, there still are seats down front. So if you want to come forward and have a seat, we'd welcome you to do so. Our guest speaker this evening is someone the students felt was understanding, a great mentor, and a teacher. Shannon graduated as an LPN from Dodge City Community College in 1996. She's had a wide variety of positions since that time, including positions at the Hutchinson Correctional Facility, Via Christi, Regional Medical Center Float Pool, and the Hutchinson Clinic. She's been the director of Collier Assisted Living at Wesley Towers since 2009, becoming an adult care home operator in 2014. She enjoys serving on the advisory board for the Hutchinson High School Medical Science Program and for the Hutchinson Community College Practical Nursing Program. Please help me welcome Shannon Dug.
Good news is, if you pass out, there's lots of people that can help you. I'd like to start by thanking you for the opportunity to be here this evening. I am honored to be here. I have enjoyed the time I got to spend with some of you this semester. This class is filled with bright and entertaining personalities. It's no doubt that the field of nursing will be better because you're joining it. Maya Angelou said, "Success is liking yourself, liking what you do, and liking how you do it." Liking yourself. If you have all worked very hard to get where you are today. You have sacrificed time with your family, your friends, sleep, and anything that requires you to spend more than $2.50 at one time. All those sacrifices are not in vain. The knowledge you have gained is yours, and no one can take that away. You have chosen a career that's rarely easy, but will repay you richly for your dedication. For some of you, this moment is the completion of your nursing education. For others of you, this is just the first step in reaching your goals. Whatever is true for you, be proud of yourself, like yourself, and know that it is truly within you to make a difference. Liking what you do. Choosing nursing allows you a wide variety of opportunities to explore. Some of you will choose to help new moms bring life into this world. Others of you will offer comfort to those whose time is coming to a close. Most of you will choose to be part of the joys and the challenges that fall between a new life and a life well lived. I received a call late one Sunday afternoon that a resident that I was particularly close to was passing away. I quickly made my way up to see him. His family was gathered at one side of his bed, so I made my way to the other side. I sat down with him and I told him how much I enjoyed our trips to the fair, how much I would miss him being with me. You see, he was my fair buddy, one of the only people that found joy and amusement in watching the fairgoers in all their splendor. I said my goodbye and he was gone. I felt at that time, and I still do today, incredibly blessed to have shared those final moments of his life. That's just one of the moments that helped me realize I like what I do. You all have countless moments like these waiting for you, moments that will allow you to say wholeheartedly, I like what I do. Liking how you do it. Let's see a show of hands. Who's ready for your first LPN paycheck? You know who wants it only more than you? The student loan people. So, nursing can provide you financial security, but there are many rewards that go far past what's in your bank account. Go to work with a passion for helping others. Not every day will be fun. Some days will feel like the worst episode of Survivor. But you will likely find that the days that are most challenging are also your most rewarding. Those are the ones that test you, that show you just how capable you've become. Patch Adams said, "You treat a disease, you win, you lose. You treat a person, I'll guarantee you'll win no matter the outcome." If you work with a passion for helping others, you'll like how you do it. As you go forth to start your careers, remember this. Forgive yourself, you are not perfect. Show yourself grace, you are still learning. Show yourself patience, you are on a journey. Congratulations on completion of your PN nursing program. Congratulations to your families for surviving their nursing program. You have worked hard and you should be proud of your accomplishments. Thank you.
I told the students today at pinning practice that at one point in tonight's pinning ceremony, I will pin my 700th nursing student, so I'm honored to be here. This evening, a pin will be presented to you as a symbolic welcome to a career in nursing. In the center of your pen, there's a Grecian lantern in honor of the lady with the lamp, Florence Nightingale, who was presented a pin from Queen Victoria for her pioneering work during the Crimean War. As you look at this lantern, I encourage you to consider what you want your nursing history to be. Will we see your names in textbooks? Maybe so. But what is even more important is how your patients remember you. You must focus on that every day of your nursing career. Around the Grecian lantern is an ocean of red. This represents all the sacrifices, struggles, and pain you have swam through to be sitting on this stage tonight. I don't want to dwell on these, but I do want you to know that in our eyes, you're warriors. Please say warrior. And you are an inspiration. Please say inspiration.
Inspiration.
And all of us celebrating with you tonight, always remember, you can overcome any obstacle thrown in your path to your dreams. You have proved that over the last 9 months. Around this ocean of red is a blue border with HCC Practical Nursing Program in gold letters. I know if I pulled you right now, none of you would probably say that your last 9 months are in the top 10 list of your life experiences. It's not easy to have faculty push you to be better than you ever thought you could be, to meet expectations that you once thought were unachievable. I understand, but remember, we told you to be sitting on this stage tonight. We must be confident that we would let you be our nurse. Would you like to know what I didn't tell you? I'm confident as time passes and you experience the real world of practical nursing, working with graduates from other programs, working in different areas of the nursing field, furthering your education in other programs, you will look back and move this experience up to your top 10. Why am I so confident? Do the names Janice and Kim ring a bell? Would they come to work for me if they didn't believe that our program was pretty awesome? I'm pretty sure both of them have told you that as students, they didn't care much for me. In fact, I'm pretty sure they probably used the word hate at one time or another. You see, the faculty and I share stories all the time about graduates coming back and telling us how they now realize what a great education they received at Hutchinson Community College Practical Nursing Program. You witnessed them yourselves during our alumni forum. We don't pay them to come talk to you. They get a sandwich and some chips. If graduates ever stop talking about how proud they are to have graduated from our program, there will be big changes. Why, you might ask? Because someday they're going to be our nurse. Throughout this program, we've spent a lot of time focusing on the science of nursing. Well, I'm not so sure Mrs. Pitzer's Bob analogy or Sarah's constant demonstration of her personal physical therapy are truly backed by science, but I'm confident you learned enough about the science of nursing to pass your NCLEX exam. You need to know that all of that knowledge won't get you the thank yous from your patients. The past 2 weeks, I asked various healthcare workers to ask patients what makes a good nurse. This is what they said. Dale said, "I want my nurse to agree with me and not that damn doctor. They're supposed to be on my side." Olivia said, "I want them to look at me when they are talking to me. Sometimes I don't know if they're talking to me, and maybe they're not." Byron said, "I love when my nurse talks to me and not just my family. I really can hear, you know." Allie, "I want to know what they are doing. It scares me when I don't know what's coming. There's a lot I can do for myself if they would just slow down and ask and give me some time." Kyle, "Quit talking like I'm not in the room." Ruby, "When they truly feel my pain." Harvey, "When they come into a room and just spend time listening to me. And Art said, a good nurse is not too busy to come talk to me, not only when I'm having a good day, but also when I just need to vent and complain. I don't need a nurse to tell me it's okay when all she wants to do is really rush out of the room. It won't be okay because I have cancer and nothing is okay with that. I need them to just sit and listen and to understand we are human and we all have good days and bad. But that doesn't make me crazy, it just makes me human. You've done an amazing job this past year demonstrating the art of nursing for each other. Please don't lose focus of that when you walk off the stage tonight. It's easy to get wrapped up in the skills and the technology, but always remember, patients extend their gratitude for the little things that we do for them. The art of nursing. Answering the call light promptly. Speaking compassionately. Giving them something to drink. Holding their hands. In all the years I worked in a urology office, I never once had a patient say, thanks, Sandy, this catheter is awesome. But many patients recall and tell me, even today, the time I sat in the room and held their hand as they processed the doctor's news that they had cancer. Think about what really matters to your patients as you venture out on your many journeys to make your own nursing history. To you, now our colleagues, I extend a heartfelt congratulations and best wishes from all of us at Hutchinson Community College.
Marissa Brookman could not be here tonight, so the class would like to acknowledge her and say congratulations, Marissa. Elizabeth Ann Castor. At this time, I would like to thank my parents for encouraging me and helping me with my son and everything else that life threw at me while I was in the program. My son was so understood on the days I could not spend time with him because I was busy with homework, yet still loved me the same. I would also like to thank my son's family for taking such good care of him while I was busy with school and being so understanding. I would like to also thank the instructors for taking time each day to be there for us and encourage us even on the bad days that we felt like quitting. And last but not least, some of the amazing classmates that I have met this year that have shown me so much support and encouragement. It was that support, I believe, that got us through the year. Yay, we did it.
Christina Cook. First, I would like to thank my family for the overwhelming support and encouragement. They have managed to deal with me and my emotional roller coaster this last year. Without them, I don't know if I would have had the strength to continue. I would also like to mention my fellow classmates. We have endured a long year together, and luckily we are a close group that can lean on each other for support. Hey guys, we made it. Last but not least, I would like to thank all of the staff. We as students have had more moments of doubt than we have optimism, but you were there to pick us up with your encouraging words. You have made sure to let us know how much you believed in us, and that support is one reason I made it to this day. It's been a great year with a lot of great moments. I will miss everyone, staff included, but I am so glad we have reached this finish line.
Kevin Dalton. Thank you to my Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ, who put me on this road to nursing, a path I never dreamed I would follow. Thanks to my wife, Gina, and son, Brendan, who believed in me, pushed me, and put up with me the past school year. Thanks to Megan for showing me the way, and thanks to our instructors for all the knowledge and experiences they have given us.
Courtney Foth. I would like to thank all of my family and friends for helping me this last 9 months. I would like to give a special thanks to Michael for believing in me and supporting me. I would like to thank my daughters, Kaya and Amory, for being amazing and understanding when I had homework all the time. Thank you, Mom and Bruce, for all the help, whether it was taking the girls, providing meals, or working on my car. Thank you to all my friends that I have met in this program. I know I was not able to thank everyone that helped and believed in me, but you know who you are. I would have not been able to follow my dream without the help of all of you.
Morgan Fruits. I would first and foremost like to thank my daughter, Miet. I know you've had to share my time, attention, and energy with school, but we have finally finished the first section towards our future. You are too little to fully understand all of our grown-up talks, but thank you for always wishing me good luck on a test, to have a great day, and remembering to ask how my day was. I love you, sweetie. To my mommy, yes, I still call her mommy at 23. Thank you for completely changing your schedule around, working every weekend, and getting up early on your days off to help with Mia, surprising her with donuts every time. Also for just listening to me complain and worry for hours on end about every little thing. I would also like to thank my sister, Jordan, all of the special things you have done for Mia and your awesome co-momming. We truly appreciate you. You and Mom have been my number one supporter since the beginning. All the phone calls to answer my questions, late night group texts, and positive words to keep me going have saved me during these past 9 months. Last but not least, thank you to the very special gentleman in my life. I greatly appreciate the little and big things you guys do for me and I. Thank you, everyone who has had to endure my crazy moods, but I finally made it to the light.
Rhiannon Graves. First off, I would like to thank God for giving me the opportunity to go back to school to fulfill my dream of becoming a nurse. Without His grace and direction, none of this would be possible. Next, I would like to thank my children. You babies are the reason I have driven to do so well in my studies, and I give myself the extra push to give you the best lives possible. I want to show you that giving up is not an option. Do well in everything you do, and I promise it will all pay off in the end. I would like to thank my fiance, K.W. McCurry. You have believed in me from day one, always cheering me on and making my study time manageable. I am not sure that every man would have had the understanding or willingness to do the household chores along with the countless hours of being a study partner, all in which you did without complaint. Even though I know you were exhausted yourself, you did it for me. You are my biggest supporter. A thank you to my mother. You always told us we could do anything. It took me a little longer than the others, but I am finally doing what you always said I could. Thank you for your continued faith in me and never giving up on me. Lastly, I would like to thank my classmates. Without the pick-me-ups when things were rough that most of us felt like quitting, we always had each other's backs. In the beginning, we were strangers. Now, 9 months later, here we are, a family of nurses. We did it.
Casey Howe. I would like to thank my fiance, Luke. Without his help, support, and faith in my dream of becoming a nurse, it would not have been possible. I would like to thank my family for all the support and encouragement. Diane for making me promise her I would finish what I started. My dad for raising me to be stubborn and never give up or back down from a challenge. To my son, Alan, and my daughter, Adelita, for making me want to be the best role model I can. My nursing family in the HCC class of 66, with whom my nursing school journey started, thank you for staying with me through it all, and all of the instructors who knew my struggle and went above and beyond to help me reach the light at the end of the tunnel.
Ann Johnson. I want to thank my family and fiance for always pushing me forward and believing that I can be a wonderful nurse. Without you all, I wouldn't be where I am today. You have raised me to always have faith and to do the very best that I can in anything that I do. Your love and support will never be forgotten, and I can't thank you enough for giving me the strength and motivation to get through one day at a time and to achieve my goals.
Kelsey Lamer. First and foremost, I want to just say, class of 69, We finally made it. I couldn't have done it without any of you guys. We have created so many amazing memories, and I wish nothing but the best for all of you. I want to thank my friends and family for being so patient and understanding with me and my busy schedule through this entire process. Thanks to my dad for always supporting me no matter what decisions I make in life and always being there to pick me up if I fall. We've been through so much together these last few years, and I am blessed to have you in my life as my dad and my rock. I also want to send a huge thank you to both grandparents, whether it was letting me eat dinner with you or just letting me come over and vent about anything and everything. You guys are seriously the best. Last but certainly not least, I want to give a special thank you to my grandma. Your unconditional love and support has honestly been what has kept me going. You've watched me cry and complain, and you had nothing but encouraging words and motivation. I know I don't tell you enough, but without you, I would not be where I am today. Thank you for being so patient with me as I grow and learn on my own. Congrats, everybody. You all will make amazing nurses.
Don Lewis. I would like to thank my family for being my support and believing in me. I would like to thank my mom, Drew, Jean, Dawn, and my best friend, Jess, and her boyfriend, Roy, for helping me with my daughter and countless other things. I would like to thank my daughter, Audrina, for her patience with me throughout this process. I love you to the moon and back, baby girl. I want to thank my nursing school friends, especially Courtney, Erica, and Clarissa, for being my allies during school. None of this would have been possible without everyone's love and support.
Tyler Marks. First off, I want to thank Caitlin. She has definitely been a huge help and support getting through this program. It has been tough, but we have got through it. To my family and friends, they have been a huge part in supporting me and encouraging me. The instructors were also a huge part of this as well. I would not know most of the information I do without them. This program has had its ups and downs, from studying to having fun at clinicals and having fun in simulation lab. My classmates have helped me get to where I am as well. I have made some great friends, and I want to wish everyone good luck and say that you will all be great nurses.
Clarissa McCartney. Thank you, Mom and Dad, for always pushing me to do my absolute best and reminding me how proud you are of me when I wanted to give up. Thank you to Andrea and Mike for showing an interest in my dreams, being an encouragement, and keeping me in your prayers during this journey. Thank you, Debbie Gieselman, for being a rock for me and helping me work through my daily anxieties, even though, as I look back now, I see some of my anxieties, though they seemed large at the time, were really a minute part of the big picture. Thank you to my daughter, Jana, for allowing sacrifice time so Mommy can make a better and brighter future for us. Finally, thank you, John, for always encouraging me to pursue my dreams. Thank you for being my solid rock and holding our family up over the past year in every way. Thank you for being my shoulder to cry on, my listening ear to vent in, and thank you for showing me that my dreams matter. I look forward to spending my life with you and annoying you each and every day. You are truly my knight in shining armor.
Erica Morrison. I have been blessed with an incredible support system my entire life, and this past school year has made that very clear. I have to start by saying thank you to my parents and grandparents for all of your support each of you have provided and for continuously letting me know how proud you are of all my accomplishments. Another huge thank you to my boyfriend, Paxton, for helping me get through the rough days by always reminding me to look at positive things in life, regardless of how small they are. You have been encouraging me to pursue my dreams since day one, and I am so lucky to have someone like you. Lastly, I would like to thank all my classmates for being my second family and providing a constant source of laughter these past couple of months. I have made some great friends in this program, and I hope that we all keep in touch.
Kendra Novak. Thank you to my friends and family that have stood by me and helped me get to this day. I am so blessed to have both of my parents' endless support, not only through this past year, but always. Thank you to my brother and sister for being my motivation. To my instructors and classmates, I am so happy to have spent the past year with you, and I wish you the best for every single one.
Teresa Pineda. Thank you to my husband, Rick, for pushing me to chase my dreams, for always catching me when I fall and helping me fly. To Bree, Jasmine, Garrett, and Eva for being the best cheerleaders a mom could ever ask for. I love you all to pieces. To my parents and family for believing in me. To my instructors for sharing their wisdom and knowledge and for encouraging us to believe in ourselves, even if that meant you made us sing. To Don Kaiser for being a rock star and helping our roller coaster ride go as smooth as possible. To my classmates for the laughs when we really felt like crying and the friendships we had formed during this whirlwind we call nursing school. I couldn't have made it without all of you by my side.
Kalisha Poulton. Wow, this year has come to an end. We did it, Class 69. I couldn't have accomplished this on my own. I would first like to thank my classmates for all of the help and encouragement. Our stories and laughs together helped get me through the long, dreadful days, and I knew that I could count on you all to give me a laugh when at times all I wanted to do was cry. Next, I would like to thank my daughter, Lily. Thank you for being patient with Mommy for the last 9 months and for telling me it was going to be okay when I wasn't sure I could carry on. Also, a huge thank you to my parents for being a phone call away when I needed to yell out in frustration or just needed someone to vent to. Also, thank you, Mom, for letting Lil and I live with you and take over watching Lily when I needed to study for tests or take her to school so I didn't have to wake her up at 5 a.m. before leaving on clinical days. Also, a special thanks to my dad for helping me financially with my tuition and to you and Katie for helping take care of Lily also when it was needed. And last but not least, thank you to Javier for putting up with my mood swings and letting me cry on your shoulder when I couldn't hold my emotions together any longer. I couldn't have done this without all of you. I love you guys.
Erica Rivera.
Yeah, Erica!
To my nursing school family, we did it. Thank you all for your friendship and support during this journey. To Dawn, Courtney, and Clarissa, you girls are rock stars. Thank you for always being there for me and for pushing me to keep going. I don't know what I would have done without you all. Thank you to all the instructors for helping me grow to become a great nurse. To my mom, dad, and Sherry, thank you for all the love and words of encouragement during these 9 months. To my biggest fans, my boys, I love you guys very much. Thank you for always lending a helping hand and for being a shoulder to lean on. I love you all.
Carrie Roberson. I'd like first to thank my classmates and all the instructors for a great year. I would like to thank my mother-in-law and my parents for all their support and always being willing to babysit my daughter, even when it meant getting up as early as 5 a.m. I would also like to thank my daughter for reminding me every day why I was going to school. And most importantly, I want to thank my husband, Dominic, for being my rock and always believing in me, even when I didn't believe in myself.
Christina Rogers. This year has finally come to an end. I could not have made it through this without the love and support of my mom, Debbie, dad, Derek, sister, Katrina, boyfriend, Rod, beautiful daughter, Maya, and many others. For everyone who has helped watch Princess while I was at school or studying, thank you. Maya, I know you have not understood why I always had to go to school, but I did it all to better the future. You truly are my best friend. I love you all. We are JD Strong.
Violet Sadusky. My husband was my strength and my light, teaching me that my dreams are worth the fight. His love and support helped my dreams come true. And after he died, I came to depend on some of you. So my friends and family who are here with me today, I am grateful for your love and support along the rocky way. Words cannot express the thanks that you are due, but I would not be here today if not for all of you.
Leah Schmitz. I want to start out by saying thank you to my entire class for pulling me to the finish line. Without everyone's support and encouragement, I could not have made it to the end. Thank you to all my friends and family for the support, especially my mom, Vicki, who financially and emotionally supported me in every way she possibly could. And also to my boyfriend, Colton, for dealing with my attitude, sass, making sure I had everything I needed, and for keeping a roof over my head these last 9 months. Thank you to Susan Johnson and Kim Folk for the countless late night text messages and phone calls for help on an assignment, even if that meant you had to get out of bed. Also to Don Kaiser for the countless colored copies. I don't want to admit it, but thank you to Sarah Reeves for sticking me in the ER for clinicals, even when I told you that you better not. Lastly, I just want to tell Grandpa Smith thank you for watching over me and keeping me safe these last 9 months from heaven. I did it for you.
Sheena Soba. This journey to receive my LPN has been very rewarding, but also very stressful and emotional. I have also been fortunate to have been given a truly knowledgeable and understanding teaching staff. They helped me to understand my studies, and without their support, this course would have been so much harder. They are truly awesome. I also want to thank my classmates. I could always rely on someone to help me when I was struggling. Thank you so much, everyone. However, I couldn't have done it without the support of my husband and three kids. They pushed me to believe in myself and allowed me to take time away from them so I could accomplish my dream. I am so appreciative of them. Thank you for always believing in me. I love you guys so much. I am undoubtedly blessed to call them my family.
Deandra Spurlock Hester. Thank you to my family for the encouragement and support during my career change into nursing. To my children, Harley, Brody, Cody, Riley, and Jaxie, you all are my motivation and inspirations to keep going and never give up. Thank you to my stepdaughter, Kylie, for all the babysitting and help. Mom and Chris, thank you for all that you have done and do. Mom, thanks for being a listening ear and my number one supporter. To my sister, JoJo, thanks for the late night conversation, cries, and pep talks. Janie, thank you for keeping up on the grocery shopping so we didn't starve. Pat, thanks for always being there for us. Matthew, I promise I will now start keeping up on the laundry and cook actual meals. Thanks, babe, for making this career change even possible and supporting our family through it. I look forward to being able to crack a cold one and play disc golf with you. Thank you to my PM gals for keeping me on track and laughing at my ridiculous comments and stories. You all have become so important to me, and I will miss seeing you every day. And to my dad, watching down on me from heaven, you made me who I am, and I thank you for it. I know I'm still making you proud, Papa. I love you guys. Thank you for believing in me and putting up with me. Go Royals.
Heather Stevens. To my parents, thank you for always being supportive with my decisions, encouraging me to follow my dreams, no matter what they were, and being the best grumpy and grandma to Hadley. To my friends, thank you for always walking beside me. To Grammy and Papa, thank you for watching Hadley after she was born so I could continue school, finish my homework, and get some sleep. She has a great Grammy. To Cody, thank you for always being so supportive. Words can't explain how appreciative I am for you. Thank you for loving me and Hadley unconditionally and never letting me quit. Class 69, thanks every one of you for being so supportive throughout this crazy transition.
Ashley Sweetock. I would first like to thank God for giving me the strength to get out of bed every morning and giving me the opportunity to help people. Thank you to my parents, my boyfriend, and my son Michael for their unending support and patience, motivation, and understanding. Thank you to my whole family for believing in me. I would also like to thank my classmates and instructors for always being there when times got super tough. I wouldn't have made it without any of you.
Melody Badauer. Without the love, support, and help of my husband, parents, in-laws, other family and friends, I wouldn't be walking across the stage today. To my husband for being my shoulder to cry on, and my son for telling me, "It'd be okay, Mama," I never would have made it. To my parents for always answering the phone and reassuring me that it will all be worth it. To my in-laws for being so helpful in watching our son during the times when things were rocky. To my grandma Pat for doing all that she was able to help us get through this time. Without all of you and the support of many others believing that I could do this, it means more than you'll ever know. Thank you, Melody.
Courtney Weaver. I would like to say thank you to all my classmates. You are all truly amazing and have been a great support system along this journey in my life. I couldn't have been luckier to have such an amazing group of people to do this with than you all. I would also like to thank my mom and dad. You two have helped so much, and I am honored to have you as my parents. Along with my parents, I would like to say thank you to my family for being there and supporting me. Another thank you goes to my boyfriend's family. You all have been great at encouraging me to reach my goals and have been an awesome support team. Last but not least, I want to thank my boyfriend, Justin. I know it hasn't been easy for you. I can be a pain, but you have stuck by my side and pushed me to the finish line. My journey is not over. It is just now beginning, and I know with all the support I have, I can do whatever I set my mind to.
Bailey Weilert. I would like to give a big thank you to my family for their support and guidance on this journey. Without them, I wouldn't be where I am today. I appreciate my parents for helping me out financially and always pushing me to be the best I can be. Thank you to my mom and Dustin for spending numerous hours with me, helping me study and prepare for tests. And thank you to my dad and Nicole for encouraging me and giving me the push I've needed to continue my education. I would also like to thank all of my teachers for believing in me and helping me get through this school year. Last but not least, I would like to thank all of my classmates for a great year and creating lifelong friendships for which I will forever cherish.
Samantha Wilhelm. I would like to thank my parents for all the support they gave me through this whole process. I would like to give a special thanks to my stepdad, Todd, for all the times he spent studying with me for tests. I would also like to give a thank you to my fiance, Corey, for all the emotional support he gave me, for wanting me to go back to school, and for all the times I would come home upset. He would always be there to tell me it will be okay and just keep going and trying. I would also like to give the biggest thank you to the best nursing tutor a nursing student could ask for. Susan Johnson spent many hours a week tutoring me. Thank you, everyone who believed I could accomplish this.
Jessica Williams. I want to thank the whole class of 69. Without the love and support of each and every one of you, I don't think I would have made it to the finish line. To my family and friends, Thank you for being supportive of this journey. You have helped me study, babysat the kids. You've just been there, and that's more than I could ever ask for. Colby and Kylie, you guys were my motivation to keep going. Lastly, I want to thank my husband. He has been my number one supporter, my shoulder to cry on. He has worked so hard so I could go to school and achieve my dream. I couldn't have done it without him.
Okay. During each pinning ceremony, we honor two students who we believe will do an exceptional job carrying out the mission and philosophy of the practical nursing program. The first award is for outstanding student. This student must demonstrate exceptional knowledge, skills, and abilities to practice safely and effectively, as evidenced by maintaining a 3.0 or higher GPA throughout the nursing program. Above all, they must possess strong leadership skills through participating on a practical nursing program committee and maintain a positive attitude. Selection of this student is done by the class as a whole, voting for the qualified students. When discussing their clinical skills, the faculty stated, "This student was wonderful with patient care, was respectful of others, and always embraced new learning opportunities. This student is always an upbeat individual, greets everyone with a smile, and easily encourages others to be upbeat as well. This individual was willing to help others in any way possible and served as a class representative on the student council both semesters. Please join me in congratulating Kevin Dalton." Our second award is for academic scholar. This award is given to the student that has maintained the highest total percentage while in the practical nursing program. This year's recipient ended up with a 97.51% average for all the practical nursing courses. There were two other students that were less than 0.75% under this student. So this was very close. Please join us in congratulating Teresa Panetta.
As we walked across this stage tonight, accepting our pin and Florence Nightingale light, photos of memories were shown on the screen above, highlighting our path filled with pain and love. Life does not slow down for our stress and pain, but we had not trudged this path in vain. Through this time, bonds have been made, bonds that time and distance shall never fade. Tears have been shed, experience and laughter shared, all for a future for which we are now prepared. Without the love and support of all of you, tonight this stage would have only held a few. Our friends and family, faculty and staff, you are the ones who helped clear this path. Here before you, we are so humble and proud, grateful for all of you in this amazing crowd. We won't link arms and ceremoniously chant kumbaya, though we are honored to share this night with you all. So here before you in our professional whites, we've been ceremoniously pinned and given our lights. On this stage, together we are the class of 69, and with all of you, may our lights forever shine.
Nursing school is tough, but there were many little quirks from each teacher that we all picked up that helped us make it through the long days. Sandy Heisler. A little backstory on Sandy. She was a nurse at a school before she became a teacher with us. Sandy had a few apparent pet peeves.
If you need to finish your conversation or use your phone, please go into the hallway. This is everyone's learning time.
You guys are making this assignment too hard.
Only sign in for yourself. Do not sign in for anyone else.
It's not prostrate, it's prostate.
Kimberly Folk. Everyone was terrified, almost to tears, when they knew they had to do their sterile catheter or sterile wound change checkoff with Kim. This earned her the nickname, the Sterile Nazi.
I survived the Sterile Nazi.
Deborah Pitzer. Mrs. Pitzer gave us funny jokes to start each day, which she referred to as her endorphins. Mrs. Pitzer was very timely. The door locked at exactly the minute and second class was scheduled to begin, and would not reopen until her first break. We had a certain someone, Kelsey, who was always making it into the classroom by the skin of her teeth.
Are you guys ready for your endorphin? If April showers bring May flowers, what do May flowers bring?
Janice Yoder. Janice always told us to smile, but for some reason, she happens to be the teacher who smiles the least. So, here's to you, Janice. Sarah Reeves. Oh, Sarah, where do we begin with Sarah? All of us were a little worried when we heard heavy metal music screaming out of her door the first day of class. We all did not know what we were getting ourselves into. and her weird back popping can't be healthy. But to our complete surprise, she has given us lots of advice. Melissa Taylor. Melissa is the cardiac queen. Most of us can read an EKG in our sleep by this point. But she did have an interesting way of explaining things and a very quick way of doing it.
Blah, blah, blah. Did you understand?
Susan Johnson. Susan has taught us many things over this school year. Susan has taught us that vampires do exist, and the zombie apocalypse will be happening. Susan has always had our back, no matter the circumstance.
What are they gonna do, fire me? Don't worry, I got you.
Judy Burkett. Oh, Judy, you're the sweetest lady, and you know we all love every bit of you. But we are gifting you a coffee cup and an organizer folder so you can stay alert and organized. And we will always remember your fabulous sense of style.
Don Kaiser, each one of us is forever indebted to you. From the very moment we all received our acceptance letters into the program, you have answered each one of our repeating questions with grace and patience. You helped us all smile from the moment we walked in the door to the moment we left. We love you very much, and P.S., I still remember the look.
We would also like to give Debbie Gieselman a big thank you for always having an open ear to listen to any of us at any desired time. And last but not least, we have Sandy Pangburn. Sandy kept us from rioting when we disagreed on our grades, and she knew exactly how to make peace between the unhappy student and the aggravated instructor. Her famous words to us were always, "Well, did you review the handbook you were given at the beginning of the year?" Class 69 would like to say thank you to all of our instructors for making this a memorable and enjoyable year. Each one of you had your own unique way of making us all laugh when we needed it most. None of us would be on this stage today without each and one of your helping ways and encouragement. Thank you all.
We would ask that everybody remain seated during the recessional so all the students can exit and the faculty, and then please join us across the hallway for refreshments. At this time, if you would bow your head for the benediction. We give thanks for these individuals before us and for all those that helped us along the way. Be with them as they leave here and go down their many different paths. May the memory of this accomplishment inspire and encourage them when they face future challenges and opportunities. And may their journey have an abundance of joy. Amen.
At this time, it's my honor to introduce now our colleagues, Class 69 of the Hutchinson Community College Practical Nursing Program.
I've been grinding so long, been trying to for years. time.